Hey guys, Worker Brazen, and welcome back to my FIFA 17 Liverpool career mode where last time I left off. I picked up wins in the league over Derby and Manchester City, and now we are into 2019, which means we're home stretch in terms of the career mode. We've turned the old bend. I don't know what I'm doing. I don't know what I'm talking about. You'll notice I am putting out the second team, similar to what I did against Derby in the first match of the last episode. Again, it's purely because I do have a game coming up in a few days against Chelsea, who are much higher in the league than Leicester.
Coming up for you, Leicester City play Liverpool. Alan Liverpool.
So, yeah.
What have you made of them recently?
They've done exactly what we thought they might.
I need to put my second team with one of these games.
Quite often it doesn't.
I mean, they're not that higher. I mean,
down there.
If Leicester were somehow beating me, they'd go on to 28 points, 2 points behind Chelsea. So, it's not that much of a difference, but
they just got a
bad hand.
The amount of goals they've scored.
If Chelsea were first, I think I might have used my second team against them.
Who's at the pitch too?
Because they're so close in the table.
Liverpool.
But Leicester are up first, so they can
against Manchester City.
Yeah, one of those
not
crazy score lines, but I think
just because it is my second
see them
team
through with another win today.
They're lacking quality because they
this is the Leicester City lineup. Cast
gave Derby
John Flanagan starts
flashing in the last.
Shot on.
It's
good play.
Derby are bottom of the table, but team still has to produce.
To take the lead.
It doesn't matter where the team they are.
Chance that was for him. By his standards, that's the
in the league. Like, take this match's real life equivalent. Everyone was expecting Liverpool to beat Leicester. Oh, except Liverpool fans, because we all knew Leicester would beat us. It didn't matter. Claudio Ranieri could have still been there, and it would have probably been the exact same results. Liverpool were terrible. Against the teams near the bottom of the league, Liverpool fucking packed their bags and went on fucking holiday. It's the same fucking joke that's been run into the ground, buried, shot while buried, then buried again.
Trying to find a way through here, probing away. Comes the challenge. Good play, but they've lost the ball now. The break is definitely on.
David. I thought I'd have more time, but Schmeichel came out.
This is a team on top of its game. It's certainly been reflected in the results. It's a run of victories, a massive run of victories to extend today.
When you look at this team and you just wonder who is capable of beating them. They look formidable.
Fernandes!
That's a fine strike.
How did I miss that?
Quite what he was hoping for.
But when he's hit it, I'm sure he would have thought that was going to bulge in the back of the net. Not quite, though.
Otavio.
Come on, win that.
Another turnover in play here with that interception.
Fernandes again. Back to Rico Henry.
on the attack here.
Bree, in from the defender. Oh, the fall wasn't good enough.
In quickly, Timotej Kolodziejczak. Flanagan.
Uses the ball.
Looking good, this move.
Moya? Sorry, that's him. No, yeah, that is Moya. I was thinking of Moore. I've had those two for... since almost the beginning of the series. And that's the first time I've gotten the two mixed up.
Just to see, maybe a sight of goal. Shot up! Oh, well saved!
I pulled it back! Maybe I should have shot it.
And that will be a free kick against
me. How's that free kick against me? That's okay, they give it straight back to me. They realized that was bullshit as well. Moya! Mokano, you fucking asshole! What was that?
Still looking to recapture
Paul. Freaking threw himself to the floor.
Prepared to go into the transfer market to do that.
I'm still waiting there.
If they do offer about £55 million, as reported, I think that's going to be accepted.
So, Emery Chan may play against Chelsea depending on what happens. Considering how close it is, he probably will, because I would have to.
Onto the attack now.
Everything would have to go swimmingly.
Keeper comes and claims it, and no great risk.
Negotiation. Spurs and Ali himself. Say again, in any kind of time before the game. I think I would probably have already had to submit contracts to him, which hasn't happened. I'm still waiting for a response.
Here's a shot.
Bid.
For the lead. Well, it's freaking.
That was a freaking close call. Ragnar Klavan, who I might be moving on as well. What might be his last game for the club? Freaking almost pulled out a freaking beauty. He scored that, I think I would have not gone through with the move, as is
first goal.
And maybe down to what the team
only level for
say in response to my bid. Manchester United are winning, they're beating Sunderland 1-0. So I need to score a goal in
the second half.
If need be, I'll bring on Daniel Sturridge and Emery Moore for the fresh legs.
Came in with a challenge. Well, they're in a good position here. It's a neat pass.
Jamie Vardy! Ooh. Come on, there's enough pressure that he put it over the bar.
In the match.
He has enough goals against Liverpool this week. And yes, I'm back at college, so this is David. Penalty!
Good slide challenge that to regain possession. It's Leicester City.
Unbelievable.
Moving forward. With some danger to the opposition now they're here.
This is it. And, throw.
And that will be goal kick.
First change of the game, Moya's coming off. I don't know what the hell he was doing there. I'm gonna also replace Mokanu with Costa Pereira. Get that double change up in Emery Moore. Will come on a little later.
Well, a real treat in store for you. Coverage on EA Sports of the Premier League fixture. Leicester City, they'll be hosting Stoke City.
Yeah, I've had a lot of supporters. Get excited about it. And I am a
surge. Foul.
Easy decision.
That has got to be a yellow card. Yep.
And that's going to mean a booking for the club.
Without question, it was not the best of challenges.
Caused himself a nuisance to Leicester, which is a good sign.
And they couldn't find the player that they were trying to pick out.
There is Sturridge.
Could be dangerous.
He's beaten the defenders. Daniel Sturridge! There we go. His 64th minute
for their excellent performance in a game where really we expected
beat the defenders. They were never going to catch.
I don't quite know what to expect coming into it.
Because in this game, his legs aren't shot to
the leading side is there.
To the point where his pace is noticeably not as good as it used to be. But in the game, he still retains all that speed, and that helped him score his fourth of the season, but more importantly, the opening goal of the game.
And you have to go all out attacking
to get that goal. And maybe I don't even have to bring on Emery Moore. We'll see how Leicester react. Good challenge by Evan. He might have opened the door for a counter attack. Daniel Sturridge. Can you make it two in a few minutes? Oh, great save from Kasper Schmeichel. Oh, Alexander Arnold! Oh, Polo got his body in the way. Here you go, Henry! Oh! Favon will send it back via Alexander Arnold. He beats Shublet! Oh! Sturridge!
Fine moment for them. They've got a
Daniel Sturridge strikes again! Unless we're not having a good time. But that was gifted his second goal.
Viewpoint on it.
Well, despite the, I'd like to say, best attempts of the defender. Great work from Alexander Arnold led to that goal, so without question.
Towards the last 15 minutes. A timely challenge. What we've got for Leicester is a substitution. This could be it.
Sturridge again.
Sturridge
blistered through the defence and completed a hat trick.
He's made them pay, and that completes a wonderful hat trick.
Absolutely.
Signing the match ball for him afterwards because of a hat trick.
Yeah, he won't forget this day in a hurry.
Fantastic.
Daniel Sturridge shocking that he's gonna push Mane and Origi for those spots, but Mane and
John Flanagan
is
looking for an opening. With
pretty much got his spot glued to the
looking to get the ball up the other
fantastic
end of the
boots that he wears.
Well, I think we're going to see some.
There's a Brian Forrest close up. Pulls last
the next few minutes. The shot's
and,
he got in the way.
Diego Origi is the top goal scorer in the Premier League, so not exactly in a position where I could justify removing him from the starting lineup, even if Daniel Sturridge has a score hat trick.
Into the attacking third.
There might be more. They're here. Feor goes for a goal, scores!
For Liverpool.
Two goals in in two consecutive games for Fayor, where he scored against Derby, and he may have ended the demolition of Leicester.
Well, if it wasn't wrapped up before, Alan, it certainly is now.
Yeah, no mercy from this side. I'm thinking about goal difference, I think, now.
His goals have come a little later than you would probably have expected, but they have come.
It's turning out to be a comfortable game.
I was hoping he would get a few goals. Timotei, his appearances Polodzi, Jack. And well, oh yeah, it's true. He is competing
very well
with Che Ojo for that left mid position, and so far.
Can happen in 4 minutes. That's what we've got of added time.
That doesn't take away from the fact that I think he's a very good player with a lot of talent. He's a Fayor.
In quickly. And in goes the cross.
Fayor with the ball into the box. It's finding no one. It's out for a goal kick, which might be the last touch of the game. Nope. Referee's gonna let go on. Nope, there's the full time whistle.
A whistle from the referee. Liverpool have won. I can't recall.
Leicester's destruction is put to an end.
A long time.
No, one team turned up. The other one stayed in the
not happy.
It was incredible to watch.
A moment for John Flanagan and playing against his former club. Daniel Sturridge has
he goes across and
the destruction on his mind from the moment I brought him
by
on.
Any player.
And
the Leicester City
it's a perfect game. He was cause. I wouldn't be surprised if Daniel Sturridge got Man of the Match. I mean, he's gotten a perfect 10. And no, I'm not making a reference to NXT superstar Ty Dillinger. Sturridge has gotten his own perfect 10. And for Eagle, all his assists all around the place. Costa Pereira got one. Not only did Daniel Sturridge provide hit off the bench, so did Pereira, setting up one of the goals. Manchester United held on to their 1-0 win over Sunderland.
Arsenal 2, Swansea City 2, Aston Villa 2, Southampton 1,
Chelsea
1, West Bromwich Albion 1. Leicester City 0, Liverpool 4, Manchester City 3,
Benjamin
County 1,
Cassier,
Manchester United 1, Sunderland 0.
Oh yeah,
Middlesbrough.
It's because I loaned him out in January. He's back in January.
Stoke City 2, Hull City 0, Tottenham Hotspur 2, Newcastle United 2.
Still not exactly.
Let's see what that means for the league tables. At the top of the table,
he could do it probably another long out. Just,
in second,
get him
Manchester
more
United
up
with 37
to
points.
Speed.
In third, Crystal Palace with 34 points. In fourth, rising up the table, are Manchester City.
Whoa!
4 points, but only behind.
Are you fucking
goal difference.
Serious?
In fifth, moving down, are Tottenham
million.
With 32 points.
Okay, Spurs, just take
Chelsea with 31 points. In 7th, West Bromwich Albion with 31 points, but only behind on goal difference. In 8th, Everton with 27 points.
I'll go 7th.
Derby County with 8 points. And then reading up the table, 2nd bottom, West Ham United with 17 points.
I mean, Dele Alli is
3rd bottom, Middlesbrough
I would
with
pay
18
it.
Points, but only behind on goal difference. 4th bottom,
if I don't have to, I would
with
prefer not.
Points, but only behind on goal difference. Fifth bottom, moving down, are Hull City with 18 points.
Training sessions. While I'm waiting for him to go back out on loan, I may as well put Kajor in to get his rating up. Huh. Now he's 23. Nicholas is no longer, or got the promising player arrow next to his name. Maybe because he's A6 rated now. I like his new picture. It's very crisp. Let's get Vallejo up to a 79. Who else is really close to a rating? Feor. He could benefit from going up to a 73 rated player. Anyone here? Yigit is pretty much already a 66 rated player. He'd probably go up in this training session just before the Chelsea game. Yep. And Shea Oja went up as well. Oh, beautiful. I probably have to relist him? I might have to relist him. Hang on a second. Shouldn't take 2 seconds. Cashier. Yeah, I do have to relist him. Okay. Trent Alexander-Arnold is to get a new contract. I'll sort that at the end of the episode. I won't do it now because I have this game to play. I'm playing against my Merseyside rivals. Who's Everton? Perhaps they can do me a favor and take some points off of United and send me one step closer to the league title. Wouldn't be the first time Everton helped me do that.
Hi there everybody, Martin Tyler here along with Alan Smith, and our match today comes from the Premier League. Chelsea playing Liverpool with a great history of the fixture and some wonderful games in recent seasons as well between the two, and they've both been going for league titles.
The ghost goal at Anfield. Plenty of history between these two teams.
It does look, Alan,
Chelsea are down 7,
horse race, but we
were able to win. They shoot back up.
Well, what I've been impressed with is the way that they've kept the focus despite this big gap. They've not rested on the laurels and heading towards being champions.
Big reshuffle for Liverpool.
Maurice
Karius is the goalkeeper today. This could be a chance.
This could be. Oh, Thibaut Courtois is equal to it. There's Roberto.
Went in well.
This is the ball pass.
That's been Equeta. There's some potential in this move.
Renato Sanchez.
Put them in front.
Renato Sanchez.
Goalkeeper has done well to stop that one.
Why?
He could be the star turn for Liverpool today.
Well, he's one of the best.
Could score.
Mane. Oh, great save from Courtois. Coutinho. Penalty. Oh, what's different from that and what you get? What was given against Derby? The ball was away. Hey, but I was still fouled. Correct me if I'm wrong, but that's exactly what you gave what the game gave the penalty for. We're in the freaking game against Derby in the last episode.
Javi Martinez.
No, I won't let it go. It's bullshit.
Jimenez.
that further proves my point. The fact that I didn't get a similar decision.
He's kept it out.
Manny.
They're grateful for that, to have an intervention like that and get back on the ball when they're defending so much. Trying to switch on the attacking power in this situation.
Renato Sanchez!
Keep it down, but it was just too high, only just.
Tried to get in, but it just didn't go down in time. Because Perchak had any significant issues.
Now they've got a chance in this part of the pitch.
There.
Gets his foot in there. It's nicely worked until that point when it broke down. Now they've got to try and regain possession. He's had to tackle there.
The corner. Jimenez. Jimenez tackle,
turning out play.
Matip! Joe Matip! Oh! I didn't freaking expect it to come. I may have jumped a little too early with Sadio Mane. Not that he should be being put on the air.
The defenders managed to get in the way there.
See.
On the front foot now, they've got a corner, hoping for the goal to put them in the lead.
That would be what for a goalkeeper can tell, man.
And in goes the cross. Trying to cross it, and in the end, a bit of a waste, I think. Robert Lewandowski. That's Philly Queta. Mikel.
Who's been mostly in the Chelsea half.
He's got his tackle in, and the ball's gone out now.
Of course, to see Mikel. Throw in his attempts to get the ball.
Hazard. Well, that looked promising.
Daniel Klein steps in and takes the ball.
Coutinho.
Sadio Mane.
He's coming forward. With some danger. The break is definitely on.
Pulls it back. To Firmino! 1-0. There's the open. No.
With this very
in the 8th minute, probably go down.
They have the ball to break them down.
But who cares? It's 1-0 just before the break as well.
It's really effective.
Origi.
You don't get away with that when you're a
his way into the position to pass the ball. And he found Firmino in acres of space. Antonio Conte. He must be absolutely fuming at that. Only his second goal of the season. And not been a prolific goal scorer this season as Roberto Firmino, but
opened the scoring.
It's not what he's paid for.
Nemanja Matic.
Oh, Origi! Oh!
He had a real go.
Probably should have made it 2-0 there. Maybe I rushed that.
Just couldn't provide the finishing touch.
I saw the opportunity.
Nemanja Matic. Mikel. Coutinho. 4 minutes of added time.
Ball
to
ball
come.
To his Brazilian. But he Firmino. Oh, that's very quick. That does enough. At the expense of a throw, but he did enough.
Roberto Firmino.
Firmino. Great ball in. Money! Oh!
Just wide.
Should have been 2-0.
Maybe he'll bury that.
Well, Mr. Smith's eyes lit up alongside me, and he's only on the gantry.
Sadio Mane.
Chance, you would have taken that chance.
Inches away. Just lost concentration. From putting in the back of the net. Connection. As is, it looks like it'll be 1-0 at halftime, and not 2.
It's Mikel.
It so will
1-0 here as the halftime whistle.
But that's okay. Oh wow, Everton are winning! So both Merseyside teams are winning.
Substitute coming on.
Chelsea, you can see now that they're gonna
to be replaced by
go more for offensive in this second.
Liverpool's
half bring on and goal of Kante.
That's untidy, foul by Lewandowski.
I think I'm being judged to foul my own player.
What we've got on EA Sports.
That's always
our presentation of the FA Cup fixture. Chelsea, they'll be facing Brighton and Hove Albion.
Yeah, it's got a good feel about it, that one. Look forward to joining you in the gantry for it.
Crosses in.
Emery Chan.
He worked hard to get the cross in, but it didn't.
Nathaniel Clyne goes for a goal.
Well, to stop that one. Into the attacking third.
Not many players will catch him.
Now Eden Hazard.
That's okay. The cross is poor and it's easily dealt with, hit by David Alaba. Now the counter attack is on.
Origi.
He can pull it back. Demery Chan. Oh, Matic. Does it not?
A clear corner.
Emre Can, who, as of this, who was looking to get another goal, well, as is, his goal in the last episode is still his, looks like it pressure may really still be his last goal for Liverpool. Although I haven't received a bid for it. Matip! Oh!
By the goalkeeper, he's hung on to the ball as well.
What about an unlikely goal scorer, especially with his feet?
Here's Renato Sanchez.
Oh, that's a foul by Rain. It's going to be a yellow card for the Frenchman. Oh no, it's a red!
Well, he's got to go. And for that kind of
the referee's dismissed Rafa Varane.
Well, he's disappointed in himself, but
I thought that was going to be a yellow. What did he get the red for? Let's have a look at this. I have absolutely no idea why he gave that as a red card. I mean, you can see Chelsea's response to it. They're bringing on Socrates. But Chelsea are down to 10 men. I'm normally the first one to call for cards, but I thought that was going to be yellow. I do not know why it was a red. I mean, the referee obviously must have saw something that I didn't.
Threat was there.
Because he's dismissed Rain.
The keeper might have been relieved there, Martin, because I don't think he would have got there.
Oh, just too high, and it was coming down too.
It's so hard to keep these modern-day footballs down, but he very nearly managed it.
Callas. Turn pass. Good strong tackle.
Tino. Much more space now that Chelsea are down to 10. Origi still can't put it in the back. And then he kicked it straight to the ground.
Divock Origi.
Origi. Well, ball for Coutinho to make it 2-0. Top corner. 2-0. Game over. The Brazilian double finishes Chelsea off. Firmino got the first goal and posts the dismissal of Rafael Varane.
And he's got the goal to show that.
I love that kind of finish.
Coutinho sticks it in the back of the net. a top corner to make it a 2-0.
Just widen the
Chelsea, we're going to have a hard time in that one. Getting back into the 10 men. But now 2-0 is a mountain of a task.
The league leaders, and they're playing like league leaders.
And they've got a swagger about them, haven't they, Martin?
Especially if there's more to come.
Stuff today.
And he's got the ball away from him with the tackle. That's Billy Quetta.
Oh, a bad mistake. Origi, 3-0. That is definitely game over.
They numerically.
Divock Origi scores another goal. Oh, oh, this one practically gifted to him by Nemanja Matic.
They've just run away from them. They're likely to do that in the match.
I look sick as a dog. He's probably thinking, what was Matic doing?
Back to front so quickly.
Goals for the season.
The margin now. 3-0
for Divock Origi, and he finally
gets time for the substitutes, I think, for Chelsea.
Luck in front of goal in this game. There are a few misses
of regular time.
But, that goal,
Eden Hazard,
3-0, definitely ends any hope of Chelsea getting back into this match, and maybe there's more. Origi again, 4-0.
Advantage here with a great goal.
And we don't always see the advantage come good, but they've made.
There's just so much space now with Chelsea down to 10.
Greater plum, I'm sure, getting the first goal gave him the confidence.
This was 3v2.
And here's the goal again.
And Origi, confidence equals precision, and Divock Origi. He gave me absolutely no question about it. A great finish. All of a sudden, Divock Origi is on a hat trick after being starved of goals
for
ages in this match. I don't know why Chelsea have brought on Genie Wijnaldum. Another bad mistake. Oh, off the crossbar. Coutinho.
Great tackle. Conte. Great place.
Conte. He loses it. It's going to come back to Origi. Oh, he can only manage to smash it into the Courtois water bottle.
That's Billy Quetta. 4 extra minutes to play here of added time. There's some potential in this move.
Nice ball across. Origi's hat trick is complete. Philip Coutinho with the brilliant pass. Origi with the finish.
They will be signing the match ball for him afterwards. Because
this game will say that Origi scored a hat trick. It'll say nothing about his missed chances as well. How much that red card has made a complete difference. Before the red card, it was 1-0. And since the red card, I've scored 4 goals, making it 5-0. Another demolishment of
a
possible tie rival. After smashing Manchester City in the last episode, Chelsea suffer for a similar fate.
It never altered for the entire 90 minutes. Wonderful stuff.
They probably can put it down to questionable red card. I still don't understand why it was given as a red card, but indeed it was. And after it was, I mean, after the red card was shown, it may as well have been game over. And it may as well be game over for the season, because Everton scored a second and beat Manchester United by 2 goals to 0.
Arsenal 2.
which means they dropped points. I'm sure.
Three. Liverpool or five.
That
Chelsea
will play. He's
Manchester City.
That'll
Crystal make Palace.
Chelsea a little bit happier.
City one. Newcastle United one. Let's have a look at what those.
I'll sort this transfer out with Emery.
With 60 points.
And possibly going to Bayern Munich. He's going to replace Renato Sanches. Who knows? Until the next episode. Well, thanks for watching. Home and enjoy. And until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.
In fifth, moving down, are Crystal Palace with 34 points. In sixth and falling are West Bromwich Albion with 34 points, but only behind on goal difference.